Yes, hello again. Yeah, welcome to computer network exercise. Today I bring you for another exercise. It's called BGP. Okay. BGP we use for route between networks and to another networks, which have a different AS number. Okay, so I will implement this protocol using GNS3 software. So I'm opening my GNS3. Just wait for the opening of my GNS3. And I will name the project called BGP route. Okay. BGP route. So, but I must wait for my GNS3 VM for starting. Let me open this. Server. Yeah, my GNS3 is starting up. So I can create a project. I call it BGP route. Okay, BGP route. So I will use 6 routers for my implementation. So let me drag and drop for 6 routers. Then I will organize it later. So I will use 1 router here, 2 router here, 3 router here, 4 router here, 5 router here, and 6 router here. Okay, move up a little bit. Then I will link these routers together. Okay, for router 1, wait, for router 1, I will use 0/0 to router 2, 0/0. Router 4, 0/0 to router 6, 0/0. Router 5, 3/0. Sorry, 3/0, 3/0. Router 2 to router 3, 3/0, 3/0. Router 2 to router 5, 2/0 to 2/0. Wait, let me check. 2/0. I want 2/0. 2/0 to 2/0. 1/0 to 1/0. Okay, let me show all interface label. And then I will assign a IP address for each interfaces. Okay, then we start assign IP address. Okay, for router one, I will use for another network which is not included in these four routers. And router 6 also another network which is having different AS number. So total we have 3 autonomous system number. So router 1 is one number, these 4 routers one number, and router 6 one number. Okay, so router 5, let me choose some color. Router 6. Let's choose another color. Router 6 and these 4 routers. We choose color. Okay. Now let me change the color. It's too dark. I don't like dark. Yeah. So these 4 routers, I will give one AS number. AS number 11, okay? AS number 11, let me make it bigger. 16. And this is AS number 22, and this network is having AS number 33. Okay, 33. So wait, I will use like this. Okay, networks between this AS number 22 and AS number 11, we will use BGP routing. Okay, so this network we use EBGP because it's different AS number, right? Sorry. Why is this one? And this link also using eBGP, but inside the 4 routers we will use IBGP, not eBGP. Okay, not eBGP. And interface we will assign IP to each interface. Okay, for router 1, we have loopback 0.192.168.1.1/24 belong to router 1. What about router 6? Router 6, we also will have loopback address 192.168.6.1/24. Okay. And about interface, this T0 slash 0 on router 1, we have 10.10.12.2, okay, slash 30. I use slash 30 for each point to point, and this interface, it must be 1, okay, it must be 1. And let me move it here so that we can see the address, this one also. Oops, why I'm not duplicate this. Okay, on router 2 interface, we have 3 interfaces, okay, T0 slash 0, we will use 10.10.23. I use 23 represent for link between router 2 and router 3, okay, just for my remember, I represent the link between routers only. You can use any other address, okay. Why I duplicate the address, but always give me this. And this interface will have .2, okay, must be .2. So let me duplicate one here. I just use this one for duplicate, okay. And this address, the link between router 3 and router 4, we will use 34.2. so here must be 34.1, okay, .1. One more here, I will move the interface name up. I will bring one more here. So this one must be 25.1, right, because the link between 2 and 5, 25.1. so this one we already have. This one must be 25.2, right? Yes, 25.2. And the other two, right, we have left 2 interfaces. This one, router 5 and router 4, we call it 54.1. So this one is 54.2, right? Yes. Now we have done assigning the address for router 1 up to router 5. So we have left the link between router 4 and router 6. Okay. Router 4 and router 6. Router 4 and router 6. We'll use this one. 46.2/30, and must be .1, 46.1, right? So now we have done assigning the address for each interfaces. So we will start configuration according to the address. So remember, I will use OSPF on these 4 routers, as the internal routing, because we will use the same AS number, because the same AS number we can use the IGP protocol. So I will use the OSPF routing protocol for routing between four routers, these four routers, okay? And I will use eBGP between router 1 and router 2 and router 4 and to router 6, okay? The purpose of implementation this network, I will make router 1 loopback address be able to ping from router 6, okay? Be able to ping from router 6. And this loopback address also be able to ping from router 1, okay, using the BGP protocol. So I guess we can start configuration. First, we need to start all the devices. Okay, and then we open the console for all nodes, for all six routers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, we have six routers. Okay, we have six routers. Let me bring this down a little bit so that we can see. Okay, we will start from router 1. First, I need to do a basic configuration, like assigning all the addresses to each interface, including OSPF in these four routers. But later on, I will apply the BGP protocol to the routers, okay? But first, I just do the basic command, basic configuration to assign all the addresses to all the six routers, okay? And then we can start see how we configure the BGP protocol. Just wait for the router starting. I think it's ready. So router 1, we give the address 10.10.12.2, right? INTG0/0, no shutdown. And then IP address 10.10.12.255.255.255.252, right? And then I will also give the description to the interface, okay? To let you know, this interface is linked to router 1, right? Link to router 2, because when you show the interface or you show the command, show the configuration, so that you can note that, oh, this interface is linked to router 2. Okay, so yeah, yes, for router 1 we have only one interface for physical interface, but we also have the loopback address, right? INT loopback 0. The loopback 0 is 192.168.1.1, right? IP address 192.168.1.1/24. Okay, /24. So we go to router 2, right? We go to router 2, enable config terminal. Then we go to interface G0/0. No shard. If I'm not giving no shard first, I might forget. Then IP address 10.10.12.1, right? 255.255.255.252. And then I also give the description to the interface that is called link to router 1. And also I will give the OSPF routing protocol for internal communication between router 2, 3, 4, and 5, but not G0/0 that is linked to router 1. Router 1 linked to router 2 using BGP protocol, right? Using eBGP routing protocol. So I go to G2/0, no shard, IP address 10.10.251.255.255.255.252, right? And description link to router 5. And I also give IP OSPF with AS number 11 area 0 on interface itself. Sorry, IP interface OSPF 11 area 0. What happened? I think I have mistyping. Okay. IP OSPF 11 area 0 because I mistyping. So I will assign all interface with OSPF itself. Okay. And then I go to G3/0 INT. G3/0, no shard, and then the IP address 10.10.23.1. Description will be link to router 3 and IP OSPF 11 area 0, right, for each interface. So I think I have done the basic configuration on router 2, so let's go to router 3. So I moved this one a little bit up so that I can see router 3. Router 3, yes. Enable cont int G3/0, no shard. Then IP address 10.10.23.2/30. The same description link to router 2, right? And then IP OSPF 11 area 0. It will be form a neighbor between router 3 and router 2, right? You see? It form a neighbor between router 3 and router 2. So next INT G1/0. No shut. IP address 10.10.34.2/30. Okay, description link to router 4. IP OSPF 11 area 0. Okay, and then I think I have done configuration on router 3. Okay, let's go to router 4. Router 4, enable config terminal int g1/0. No shut. IP address 10.10.34.1. And I give description link to router 3, right? And IP OSPF 11 area 0. Then it will form a neighbor between router 3 and router 4. Okay. Yes, it's up. Then we go to another interface, G3/0. No shut. IP address 10.10.54.1. Description link to router 5. IP, sorry, I just use this one. Yeah, that's it for router 4. Then we go to router 5, right? Router 5. Router 5. Enable cont int g2/0. No shut. IP address 10.10.25.2. Description link, let's make capital L, link to router 2, right? And then IP OSPF 11 area 0, right? And then we go to another interface, INT G3/0. It's supposed to form a neighbor between router 2 and router 5, right? You just wait. It's supposed, right? Because we just added OSPF here and 2/0 we already added. I will check it later after I complete this interface. Why is not form a neighbor? Yes, it's form a neighbor now. Just take some time. So we go to another interface, G3/0. No shut. IP address 10.10.54.2. Description link to router 4. Then IP OSPF area 0, yeah. It's supposed to form a neighbor from router 4, router 5. Now it's on, right? So we have done configuration for 5 routers already. So we still have one more router. Okay, one more router, router 6. We go to router 6, enable, cont, then int g0/0. I think I have confused g0/0. Did I use OSPF here on router 4? Did I confuse to add? Let me check. Let me check router 4, right? Router 4, we have given IP address to g1/0, and then we given to g3/0, but we haven't given to g0/0 yet, right? So yeah, let's assign, right? Just confirm router 4 g1/0 and 3/0, but no 0/0, right? Int g0/0 on router 4, no shutdown. IP address 10.10.46.1. Description, link to router 6, but I will not give any OSPF protocol because we will use BGP protocol here. So I go back to router 6, no shut on g0/0, and IP address 10.10.46.2. Description, link to router 4. Yeah, so now we have done all the configurations for all 6 routers. Like given IP address for each interface, and for these 4 routers we already implement and given all the addresses. So also we have given the OSPF routing protocol here, and then next we will configure BGP. Okay, so yeah, to implement BGP we need to take care of AS number, and also we need to take care of the network address. Okay, if we assign the local address or the loopback address is with /24/24, we need to advertise the network exactly subnet mask you have assigned on the interface. Okay, just remember that if you just assign address, network address and subnet mask as the default, like here I'm using default, it's no problem. But if you are doing a subnet, you need to give exactly subnet mask. Okay, this is you need to be careful. Okay, so next we will go to implement the BGP protocol, right? Okay, let's start configuring BGP. So first I will start from router 1 BGP to router 2. Okay. So I go back to router 1. I exit from the interface. Then I will start using router BGP. Sorry. BGP. What is my AS number? Is 22. So my AS number is 22 because I am on router 1. Okay. Then I type neighbor. Then my neighbor IP address 10.10.12.1 is my router 2 interface. Okay. And the remote AS number is 11. Okay. I am on remote AS number 22 and I want to connect to remote AS 11. When you say this one, it means that you are doing a eBGP routing protocol, because you have a remote AS number here and your AS number, your own AS number is different. Okay. Enter. Okay, next I will give the description. So description eBGP to router 2. Okay, and then I want to advertise my loopback address 192.168.1.0. As I told you just now, if I assigned the address with /24, I need to give the exactly mask address here. Okay, subnet mask here. So I advertise network 192.168.1.0 is the network address, not host address. Okay. Mask 255.255.255.0. This BGP protocol is not using wildcard mask. Okay. So, yes. On router 1 is done. So I go to router 2. Before I go to router 2, let me check my BGP status. So IP BGP. Okay. So IP BGP. You have advertised network. One network was advertised. What is the next hop? Is your own self, because you are on router 1. So how to reach 1.0? Is next hop is 00, it means yourself, okay, your own network, because you are on router 1 and this address is on local. Okay, it's on local. Then we show another BGP summary. This one we haven't formed a neighbor between router 1 and router 2 yet, because we haven't enabled on router 2 for BGP yet. So now we go to enable for BGP. Okay, so let's me type router BGP 11, because we are on router 2, we have AS number 11. Okay, then neighbor 10.10.12.2. Okay, remote AS number 22, right? Yeah, and then you see the message, it's already for my neighbor. You see the message, BGP is already for my neighbor, is up. So I want to give a description. eBGP to router 1. Okay, and I I am not advertise any networks from my router. If you are if you willing to advertise to router one, you just advertise whatever you want. If you don't want, just don't advertise. It's just for my neighbor. It's just for my neighbor. Okay. So let's go back to router one. See the message again. Yes, now we can see the status is up. How many minutes? It's already 1 minute is up. Yeah, 1 minute is up. So is there any preferred sharing? Not yet. We haven't learned any preferred from other networks. We haven't learned any networks from router 2 because on my purpose here, I want to router 1 can reach to router 6 and router 6 can reach to router 1, and these 4 routers just a transit routers. Okay, just a transit routers. Okay, so now we can see that our eBGP is already from a neighbor. So I want to show on router 2 as well. So IPBGP summary. Yeah, I have learned one network from router 1. Okay, this is my neighbor. So if I show like this, you can see this this is network from router 1 and this is the next hop. According to this table, it means that how to reach the .1.0 network. This is the valid and best part. So valid and best part to reach the 1.0 network. What is the next hop? Is this address. So where is this address? Here on router 1 interface. So if you want to reach 1.0 network from router 2, you can go to this network, to this address, and then you can reach the 1.0 network. Okay, and you can see where it is come from because of the BGP is the path vector protocol. So you can see where this come from. It's come from AS number 22. Okay, it's come from AS number 22 because we advertise from router 1 this address, and router 1 having AS number 22. Okay, so we will also form a neighbor between router 4 and router 6, right? So let me do it like just now. I go to router BGP 11 neighbor 10.10.46.2, this address. Okay, remote AS number 33, right? Remote AS number 33. And then I also want to give the description eBGP to router 6, right? eBGP to router 6. And then I am not advertise any networks, right? So I just want to form a neighbor between router 4 and router 6. So let me go to router 6. Okay, go to router 6 and then I go to router BGP 33, right? And then neighbor 10.10.46.1, isn't it? IP address on router 4, G0/0, remote AS number 11, right? And description eBGP to router 4. You have seen this message, it's already formed up the neighbor, BGP neighbor, okay, between router 1, sorry, router 4 and router 6. So I can go to check. Oh, I need to advertise first. Conti router BGP 33. I need to advertise my network 6.1. Okay, so it must be 6.0. 192.168.6.0 mask 255.255.255.0. Okay, so let me check the status of my BGP. So IP BGP summary. I have formed a neighbor between router 6 and router 4. Okay, this is eBGP routing protocol. So as I told just now, these four routers will be using for transit. Okay, these four routers will be using for transit. So how to transfer your message from router 1 to router 6 and router 6 to router 1? You need to form a neighbor between these four routers as well. OSPF is already a routing network in these four routers, but if you are using only OSPF, the BGP here is not able to pass by these two routers, okay, router 5 and router 3. Actually, you are connecting directly to router 2 from router 1 and router 6 directly to router 4. But these two routers need to go through router 5 or router 3. Okay. So you need to form a IBGP neighbor between the four routers. And also you need to do a mesh topology. Why? Is you have to form a neighbor from router 2 to router 5, 2 to 3, 2 to 4, 5 to 2, 5 to 4, 5 to 3. Okay, all routers. Okay, so let's start. Let's start from router 2. Config terminal router BGP 11 neighbor. I want to link from router 2 to router 5 first. Okay, so will be 10.10.25.2 remote AS number the same as my own, right? Okay, remote AS the same. Router 3. Oh, one thing, you need to give this command as well. NetHub self. You need to give the command NetHub self to each router 2, 5, 4, and 3. Because when you send a message from router 6 to router 4, router 4 will know how to go to router 1 from router 5 or router 2 or router 3. Okay, because I will show you just now. I will show you. So I will give the description. IBGP to router 5. Okay. So next, I will link to router 3. Router 3 23.2 remote AS the same, and 23.2 also NetHub self, and description IBGP to router 3. Okay, next I will link to router 4. Okay, router 4 54.1. Okay, remote AS number 11, description IBGP to router 4, and then next hop cell. Okay, as you see, this is the same repeat, so I want to copy, and I will start a notepad. It's more easy to copy and paste. We have done assigning the IBGP for router 2, so I also want to assign the IBGP for router 3, router 4, and router 5. So I will copy and paste here. So I want to remove this one. Just a minute. Okay, so if I on router 5 and I want to link to router 2, 4, and 3, okay? So let's see this. I want to link from router 5. So my neighbor will be 25.1. will be to router 2, okay, 1. So this is we have repeated router 2. I link to router 2, and the second one, let me break it here, router 3. Router 3 23.2, router 4 54.1. okay, done. Just copy, go to router 5. Okay, exit router BGP 11. Okay, then we paste all. What is this? Cannot configure the local system. Oh, sorry. I did not change the address. Yeah, I did not change the address. This must be one. So one more. Okay, one more here. So I just do it again to make sure I have everything. No error. No error. I have formed a neighbor between router 5 and router 2 already. You see, form neighbor already. So next, I will go to router 4. Let's say router 4. Router 4, this one 54.2.2.2, link to router 5. I link to router 3. So here 33.1, here's 34.1, here's must be 34.2. Router 3, 34.2. And I link to router 2. Okay, 25.1, the same. Okay, so copy. Go to router 4. Yeah, I am on router interface already, so just paste. Done. Router 3, router 2, done. Router 4, done. Router 5, done. Router 3 not yet, sorry, router 3 not yet. So if I'm on router 3, I will link to router 2. Router 2 will be 23.1, link to router 2. And I link to router 4. Router 4 must be 34.1.1.1, and link to router 5. Okay, router 5, 54.2, the same. Okay, or I can use 25.2. It's up to you. Okay. Link from 3 to 5. Either this interface or this interface. Okay. Copy. Go to router 3. Exit. Router BGP 11. Okay, that's it. So we have done configure IBGP in the four routers. So we have formed a neighbor between other three routers. We are on router 3. We have formed with router 23 is router 2. This one router 5. This one router 4. Okay. So let's check our status. Okay, let's check our status. Let's check first check on router 6. So IP BGP summary. Router 6 has advertised one network. Okay, has advertised one network. It must be learned from router 4, so it will take some time because on BGP message will refresh every 60 seconds. So we just turn up all the IBGP already. So we just wait for the message, so we can say that I think the configuration is done. We just want to verify. So I'm on router 2. I just want to verify by showing IP BGP. Okay. We need to wait for some time. So IP BGP summary. Okay, we have neighbor with AS number 11. We have neighbor with AS number 22, right? So all neighbors are up. Okay, we have learned from router 4 one prefix, and we have learned from router 1 prefix. It's mean one network has advertised from router 1. One network has advertised, and we learn it from router 4. Okay, from router 2 we can see this. What about router 4? Show IP BGP. Okay, router 4 we have detected 1.0 and 6.0. Okay, 1.0 and 6.0. Where is 1.0 coming from? It's coming from AS number 22. Where is the 6.0 coming from? It's coming from 33 AS number. Okay, so let's check here. So IP BGP, we have learned from router 1. Okay, this is what we want. This is what we want. Okay, so where does this network coming from? It's coming from AS number 22 and then across or we can say transit on AS number 11 and then arrive to this location. Okay, so let's try to ping from router 6 to router 1. Okay, ping 192.168.1.1 is the loopback interface. Why we cannot reach? Okay, because let's see on router 1, we cannot reach. Actually, we have learned router 1 in our routing table, but why we cannot reach? So let's check on router 1. Router 1 also learned from 6, right? Where does it coming from? 33, 11, and then this location. And then we ping it back. Try 192.168.6.1. It's also not respond. Why? You see, because router 1 and router 6, they know each other only. They did not know this interface like 54.1 or 54.2 or 25.2 or 25.1. They don't know. They don't know these addresses. Okay, so if you want to ping from router 1 to router 6, like 1.0 network to 6.0 networks, you need to give the source 192.168.1.1. Okay, this is the successful connection from router 1 and router 6, because router 6 recognize only from 6 network. Router 1 recognize only from 6 network. Sorry, router 6 recognize from only 1 network. Router 1 recognize from the source of 6 network. So let's try to ping again, and we give the source 192.168.6.1. We say that, yeah, I want to connect from my address to your address. Okay, it's successful. So this is the configuration of BGP routing protocol, and my implementation is using for transit routers. This is the transit routers, okay, and the other two is the link between those two networks. Okay, so I think that's all for my implementation on BGP routing protocol. So if you don't have any concept and you don't understand, please comment on my video, below video, so that I can answer your question. And once again, thank you for watching, and please do a subscribe and share my video to your friends. Okay, thank you for watching.